Okay, so here we are in ICC, and we're about to do a temple run, helping out Soul Whipper get some XP. So this is... Gotta go in this building here. Do a quick quest, and then you just gotta right-click on this thing here, and off to TOTW you go. Sure, we're in the right GS. Sometimes there's too many people in the first GS, so they gotta go to GS2, GS3, which is the same dungeon but a different instance. These are lower level mobs. This is near the beginning of the dungeon. Thank you. I don't know what items he needs. Probably needs quite a bit. I should have just checked what he's wearing. I could just click on the guy, click T, inspect his equipment. So yeah, he could use the belt off of Gott. And wristbands. Holy macro, this guy needs a lot of help. His level 30, he should have at least 50, 60 implants on easily. So we'll pretty much take him all around Temple of Three Winds, getting him some really nice items, including some nice shoulder pads, which he desperately needs. Robe there, he'll like that. That's if we don't die before we get there. So this is a, I guess, a very popular spot for level 20 to 60, especially for people that just have Froob accounts, because you could play in this dungeon anywhere on Rubikaw, actually, if you have a Froob account. But for paid accounts, they spend a lot of time on Shadowlands. Drops a nice implant, actually. I think it's called Keeper's Vitality. Thank you. I'm looking for an aggro enhancer, but I don't find one. Okay, so this guy in the middle drops the blue robe, which is the Nelib robe, I believe. I don't have it because I got Guardian tank armor. Let's see. Yeah. So he drops it 100% at a time. And let's just hope to God that this metaphysicist doesn't send his pets on the big guy in the back, or else we're all dead. If you start attacking him, once you kill him, another boss even stronger than him appears, and then you got to kill him, and then a third boss even stronger than that appears. So he's going to get the blue robe right here and probably put it on right away. Oh shit, I saw him move. I almost peed myself. After this, we'll probably go see if Gott's there. Kill Gott, he'll get the belt. And then we'll head over to Liang to get him some NCU. The more NCU you have, the more buffs you can have, so the stronger your tune will be. So it looks like we cleaned this area. We can go down the sides even to kill. I guess I'll show you on both sides. Let's wait for him. And then on both sides, you have mobs. That's going to give him more XP. He's probably just checking out what's on the... Yeah, so he's picking up a couple of weapons. Actually, my adventurer, the double-headed saber-tooth, has very nice pistols that come off of the final boss in Foreman's, which is a max level 100 dungeon. You hear Gott. Gott's there. You could see his leg here in the doorway. So he's a pretty big one. Let's hope we can kill him. don't want a Mongo in case. Taking so much damage on the adventurer. Look at that lucky bastard. Look what he's getting. Guardian tank armor, which only drops one in every six. Don't tell me he's gonna leave it there so somebody can walk by and grab it. Suck pretty bad. Since I've farmed like over 120 of them easily. So now we're going to head over to Lier, get him a couple of shoulder pads, which are very good at his level. He might have to buff up a bit before he could wear them. This is one of, I would say, hundreds of dungeons in temple in Anarchy. So the only reason I'm stopping to kill these gray mobs is because I don't want the 38 MP to take aggro and end up dying if I keep running through. So I see I just saw a shade. But we're gonna have to give like another level to the metaphysicist before I can invite him. this guy, Defender of the Three, he nukes the area. So he drops like an AoE bomb, which does damage to everybody that's standing in the vicinity. So if ever you have low levels in your team, it's better that they stand down there in the back so they don't take damage, especially if there's no doctor around. But we do pretty good damage, so he doesn't live that long. So pretty much everybody that that's Froob with a lot of paid, like the Shade that we just saw, you can only have a Shade if you pay your if you have a paid account. So I'm gonna wait till he gets to 40. Hopefully he doesn't. So this guy drops the first shoulder pad. So this is going to be a nice item for our low level MP. So the reanimator drops the other shoulder pad. So he's 39, let me see. No, we gotta give him one more level. He's 56. I think 56 should be able to level to team with 39, but it's given me a warning that he won't get XP, which I think is incorrect. So now I was just telling him to let me know if he doesn't get XP. So if he doesn't get XP, we'll have to have the Shade leave and grab him back as soon as he gets one more level. Thank you. So we'll let the Shade get his XP while he's waiting for him to level. Which shouldn't take too long because these guys are red to him because he's only level 38 or 39. So as soon as he hits 40, we're good. These are, we call them Legos, Deathless Legionnaires. But yeah, for years people just say, let's go do Legos. Behind this wall is the big fella. Usually it's good to have a twink tune or have outside buffs from higher level professions. I have a healing buff from a fixer right now, which is the reason you don't see my life going down, my health going down too often. Quack! Alexa, set the alarm for 8:30 a.m.
Alarm set for 8:30 a.m. tomorrow.
Better when the enforcer has the attention and is getting hit. Thank you. drops a nice nano for Metaphysicist. So he's going to get a nice nano here. He's going to get some nice NCU. It's like Christmas today. So he's got one NCU and he's got one ring. Oh no, the nano is dropped by the other boss. And this is a nice weapon too. This is my preferred weapon, two-hand edge, to get before I get Panther or I'm able to use Panther. I like to use this one. So you're guaranteed 227 damage, minimum damage. And there's a quick respawn here too. So a lot of people come here until they're probably level 60 before they head off to Foreman's. You have to be careful if you're a clan or if you're going to Foreman's, because they have guards there which are Omni, so they may attack you on site. Which doesn't bother me none, since I have about 300 toons that are all Omni. I can't believe this guy's not 40 yet. 60 metaphysicists is leaving bodies everywhere. He's a big fella. So as you can see, I'm level 50 on this enforcer. And I think he's not too bad. He's got like 125 to 130-ish implants, which is, I guess that's when, you know, people take the time and dress him up. It's a lot easier. This drops here in Temple of Three Winds. Actually, my head here, I think I have it in my inventory. Yeah, I do. This falls in here as well, off the big boss at the end, which we can't kill by ourselves at this moment. I usually kill those with my 60 twinks. Yeah. So I believe there's one, two, three, probably three or four implants that drop in here in total. There's an arm that drops off the boss in the middle door. But I don't think too many people use that. I never have. But yes, it is free. It is nice. It adds to strength, which is a good twinking implant. Especially if you don't have much credits. Free stuff is good stuff, especially when you're a froob and you don't have many credits. We'll go up the side this time. Actually, no, there must be five implants. Maybe I forgot about the Keeper's Vitality. Who knows, there might even be more than five. I can't remember, but there is a lot. So in here I usually kill the weaker guys first, because if you kill the harder guy and it takes a long time, you're taking damage by two or three other mobs that are lower level, but you know there's three of them doing damage to you, so that's how people die sometimes. See an engineer over there, level 40, getting XP. So that's it. I don't think we're going to see the big boss being killed today, but if you want to watch me die, so I'll just take him back down the side door. Okay, I have to run. Oh no, I'm not even gonna die. I'll just take him back out. He says his highest level tune is a 79 fixer. Time is it? Yeah, I think it's too late. I was gonna offer to power level him, but I think I better go to bed. guess I'll try and get them to 43. Actually, I should have taken him to get some more NCU. Thank you. think those pistols are pretty kick-ass. Called the Customized IMI Desert REIT 1000. 1.3 second attack and recharge, and 65 to 143 damage. So it looks like doing a fair amount of damage. Weapons wear looks pretty funny, actually. He's got on carbonum breastplate, carbonum armor, which is the least expensive, probably quality level 91 on a 50, so that's pretty decent, and that is upgraded with an omnifier to give it extra stats. Thank you. He's 43, so my job is done. Okay, so I'm gonna let you guys go. I'm just gonna finish this, run him out, and that's it.